Nose. Hello, this is Sally Morgan, physical therapist, craniosacral therapist, and Tellington T-Touch practitioner for animals and people. This is Tristan. He's a corgi, and this is an episode of Conversations with a Corgi. Coming up to 450 here in the next couple of weeks. I can't believe it. When I started this, I said to my sister, well, I can probably do 100. but it just seems to happen every day or most days. Anyway, we are in the middle of a little series talking about things you can do with your pets when the weather is bad outside. So yesterday we had a lot of rain and we talked a lot about some cognitive things you can do with your dogs indoors, some different kinds of puzzles. And today it is 28 degrees, high winds, everything that was melted is frozen, ice rink. We probably will be able to do a walk, but if we weren't, because there is an occasional bit of snow, there are some indoor things you can do with your dogs physically to help keep them going in the winter, because we all have this problem no matter where you live. It's too hot, it's too cold, it's too wet. There are many reasons why we don't go outside with our dogs as long as we would like to because of the weather. So, of course, the easiest indoor activity for their physical exercise that you can do is playing retrieving games, throwing something and having them bring it back, or getting up and, you know, having them follow you while you're squeaking it, those sorts of things. We have certainly in the corgi world seen pictures online of Karen Tindall with her dancing dogs. And dog dancing is such a fun thing. Just put on some music that makes you happy and get some toys or treats and get your dog to follow you around the living room. And that is really a lot of fun. It's good for you, it's good for your dog, and you don't need hardly any space to do that. Karen has shown us that you just need like about a 6 by 8 foot space with a border collie to be able to do that if you're creative about making circles and doubling back and going forward and back. And you know, as you're doing this, you can ask your dog to do some of the tricks that he might have, which might just include sitting and down and give a paw and things like that. And in fact, you don't have to do your tricks during the dog dancing part of your activity with your dog indoors. You can do the tricks separately. And you know, we all need a little brush up period. And if your dog, for instance, always gives his left paw, spend some time teaching him to give his right paw. That will be good for him cognitively and physically. And then you can have a bigger variety of what you can teach your dog to do from there. I have found myself in dog dancing that giving a paw is the start of many wonderful things, such as teaching your dog to strut, like in Spanish walk with horses, teaching your dog to rock side to side, teaching your dog to put his feet on your feet. I mean, there are just a lot of things you can do once you've got your dog familiar with the idea of lifting a paw. Tristan, you lift your paw all the time now. It's his default trick. He knows that mommy thinks it's so cute. So it's always good to review your basics with your dog if you're trapped indoors, and it's fun for you and fun for him because there's treats involved and you both are happy. The other things I suggest are taking pieces of the Tellington T-Touch Confidence course and using them indoors. So one of the things we talk about is the labyrinth, which is that little thing we lay on the ground with PVC pipes usually that are interlocking capital letter F's. But you don't need to put the whole labyrinth out in your house. First of all, if you have a kitchen, you can use painter's tape, even on the rugs, and make a labyrinth with that. Or you can just put lines on the floor with the tape and have your dog walk over the tape or around the tape. And you can also use wrapping paper rolls for your dog to work over, under, around. And you can put them out and make little jumps for your dog on the carpet, not on the floor, because sometimes they will slide on the floor. We have one of our agility tunnels that lives in the kitchen. It's really a long one, and I can snake that all around the living room and the dining room, and they can run all over the place in there, so that's always a fun thing. So these are a couple of ideas you can use with your dogs indoors to keep them physically moving. You know, the retrieving games are one of our default ones. If it's a really long spell, like several days, like poor Danny, she is so snowed in and frozen up there in South Dakota. You can do something really simple, like just running up and down the stairs. And if your dog, I don't recommend doing this with some breeds because stairs are not easy for dogs, but I have carpeted stairs and they're pretty shallow. So as much as stairs aren't great for Corgi's backs, he can run up and down the stairs with me a few times and, you know, we get a little excitement. I also hula hoop sometimes in the kitchen and he runs in circles around me. So there are quite a few different activities you can do with your dogs inside. And I love to just use pieces of agility, like make little jumps. You know, you can just take two pillows and a roll of wrapping paper and a broom and have a little jump in the living room. And the kids, of course, love watching your dog go over the jumps. And again, don't do this too much because your dog probably isn't used to jumping and you're in the house, so he's not necessarily getting an ideal running start and landing. But look at some of the activities that dogs do in agility. With the jumps and the weave poles too. You can have them weave around furniture. My favorite thing to do, besides playing squeaky retrieval with my dog, is to just get some treats or a squeaky in my hand and just go all over the house playing follow the leader and having him follow me. If you have a corgi like some of the ones I've had who love to chase the vacuum cleaner, get out the vacuum cleaner and vacuum around the house with the corgi or your other dogs chasing the vacuum cleaner. This can also be good for their exercise when they can't go outside. So there's quite a few options, and I'm sure you guys can think of many more. And one of my friends actually has a dachshund with some back injury. So if she can't go out for a normal sedate walk on a leash, she can't really play retrieving games because she gets too excited and she hurts her back sliding on the floor. So she bought a dog treadmill. And you can walk on a human treadmill with your dog if you happen to have one. Just really be careful how you're teaching your dog about the treadmill. Put him up there with a bunch of treats to start, you know, turn it on for like 10 steps, turn it off, kind of a thing. And certainly, if you have a dog the size of mine and he's having trouble on the treadmill, I can reach down and pick him right up. Of course, I'm a very good treadmill walker, but not everyone is. So be aware when you put an animal on the treadmill. I mean, they do this for stress tests with horses and things, they can't really stop. They can't tell you when they're done. Now, my friend with the dachshund just really kind of slows down and looks around like, get me off of this thing. But when she wants to walk on it, she does go over and stand on it. So the treadmill is kind of like the hamster wheel for dogs. And so that can be another thing you can get for your animals, especially if you're trying to keep them in peak physical condition, and you live in a really bad climate for heat or cold. A dog treadmill can be a wonderful thing. One of the other things I've done in the past when I had a dog with DM, I took a kid's swimming pool and filled it with water in my basement, which was warm because the heater was down there. The water wasn't that warm. I mean, it was like in the 70s or something, but you know, it's winter. You don't want to really be in the pool. But that corgi had DM. I put a lot of salt in that pool and I had him swim in that pool quite a few times in the winter because there weren't dog swimming pool places around here at that point. I think my basement pool was the first one. And so Winnie had a whole winter swimming in the basement to help with his DM. So, yeah, your three corgis chase each other and they keep each other active. So, yeah, get a kitten and that'll keep your dog active. So, there's quite a few things you can do to help with your dog's physical motivation in the winter when you can't go outside. And of course, when they can go outside and there's light, new, fluffy snow, and you know, you can spend a few minutes running around outside with them, they are just thrilled. But just like people, they get cabin fever. So use your intelligence to figure out some fun things to do with your dog when you're trapped indoors. So we have a lot of work to do today, even though it's a Saturday. I have my taxes. I have to get ready for this conference in 2 weeks, which seems like almost tomorrow, even though it was yesterday when it was months away. And I'm still working on another little project that I have to wrap up. So we'll see you guys tomorrow. It's windy and cold here. It's Stay warm where you are. I think there's only a few more weeks of winter, and if you listen to Phil, not even that many. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Have a great day.